A roseate spoonbill flew through the square in Lis Vender's head. With it came the thought that calico cats are the hot fudge sundaes of the feline world. Then a white-throated robin with a sprig of parsley in its beak flew in. It brought the memory of his grandmother, telling him that video games would rot his brain as a child. Thankfully, he was an adult now, so it didn't matter. Finally, a brown potu came crashing through the square after a week-long methamphetamine binge. Its eyes were wild, but no one could tell. The thought it carried was so profound that it couldn't be expressed in language. It could only be felt. It felt like a sample of polypropylene, high-pile carpet.
Hello all, it is I, Lis Vender, and it's a cold, drizzly day where I'm at right now, but I'll tell you that I am steamed. Steamed, I tell you. Ugh. Very steamed. Do you ever get embroiled in a conversation online? Yes, I know, bad idea already. But just embroiled in a conversation where you know for certain that there is only one standpoint, and you, there's no other decent perspective on it. And yet people still come at you. Well, that's been going on with me these last couple days. I don't understand it. I don't want to go into the topic specifically because it's... But I'll just say that it's one that Chris Hansen used to be involved in some years back. And I just feel like there's only one perspective to have on it that's proper. Only one decent way to approach it. And people will still be like, yes, but it might be okay if... It could be okay if... And I'm like, no, there is no if. It's not okay if... It's never okay if. I'm still kind of seething about it, so forgive me. So I'm trying to blow off some steam, this angry steam that's welling within me, by doing something positive. Maybe I can get some creative work done. I'm trying to get a little animation done on this project I've had for a while, and maybe see if it gives me some fulfillment. Anyway, let's see what we're looking at. We're looking at a dialogue shot. Well, it's all dialogue, but trying to get a...
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
We're trying to get this character to say this line, and he's doing a stretching movement where he's kind of looking at his hands, and then he looks upward because he's having an emotional epiphany, or an intellectual epiphany. That's as far as, or at least as intellectual as it gets for this particular character. And we need to make sure that the mustache moves correctly as he does the first pose.
What if we pray?
And then we've got to make sure that the mustache moves properly as he tilts upward into the second pose. So I haven't drawn the mustache yet on the second one, but I have penciled it. Right now this is all pencil. I'll see if I can do some inking afterward. Just a second. Okay. Now I've... what's going on? I'm getting a suggestion, but close that. I can't see what it says. Okay, it says I'm excellent. I'm looking at this because there's still stuff I don't know. I need to see. I want to see what's going on with okay, participants. Okay, that's how you do it. I want to play a little safe here, because especially after this argument I had made me go, you know what? What am I supposed to do if I get someone disagreeable in here? Not that it's probably ever going to happen. I'm just not that popular. But mostly I just do this for my friends and family. But just in case, what would I do if I have to do that? How do I get rid of somebody who's causing trouble or spamming or doing some other crap that's just disruptive and unpleasant. I think I can view participants here in OBS, so that's a little new to me. I should probably turn timestamps on too, just in case I miss something, so I can see when someone came in. Let me save this. Okay. But I'm not going to do this silently. I've got to put some music on in the background here. It's, there we go. Alright, to the tablet, everybody. Okay, so let's listen to the line at this frame.
Prayed.
Now, so it's just saying one word, prayed.
Prayed it.
And after he gets to that phase, his body's not going to move, but his mustache will move to indicate the movement of his mouth. So, since it's all just one long word, there's not a lot of syllables, just one syllable. I mean, there's kind of little motions that are going to be in there. I don't think I'll need to add additional frames to show the mustache moving. We'll just go. It starts with the P, so we're gonna exaggerate this. We're exaggerating the P sound by making the mustache tucked in. I'm gonna make the mustache tuck in a little bit. I'm gonna have to draw through, and that might be confusing. So even though we're drawing on the same layer, we don't have to do two layers because I will use a different paint color here. Just to avoid confusion when I ink it. Now he's simultaneously, the mustache is going to be puffing up upward, and at the same time the nose is moving downward. So we kind of have to do it, just kind of guess how it will look. I mean, because this is a cartoon and the characters are so exaggerated and cartoony, I can kind of get away with ridiculous motions here. So we're doing a puffing of the mustache to indicate that he's pressing his lips together to say the P. Now in the next frame,
pray,
he's still kind of saying a P,
pray,
and the R sound comes out in the third frame. This may not play out quite the way I'm hoping, but I'll keep it up. I'll start unfolding the mustache here. And at least maybe doing a little bit of a stretch with it, too. Let's do a little bit of a stretch. So that way it gives, kind of makes it look, the mustache look flexible because it's made out of hair. Well, I mean, the whole character's flexible because he's supposed to be like a slime character. I kind of like the way that looks. Oh, excuse me, sorry, I've had some Pepsi, so I need to... I don't want to belch in your folks' ears. Where am I at here? Maybe do a little bit more. I kind of like that. I like the way that looks. Yeah, that's kind of satisfying. I like seeing it pulling on this big mass right here. This little shape right here. I don't want that shape to be obvious, and it won't be anyway because the hand will be in the way. But I like that look that it's like pulling it upward. And let's have that shape stay there too. Kind of want it to pull it, make it concave to get a stretching effect, so let's do that. Okay, now frame 3, he starts saying the R sound. Let's see.
Braid.
So he's not saying the A sound yet, so I won't have, his mouth is not stretching out. He's saying purr. Like, imagine if you're saying purr, P-R-R, purr, your lips would go outward. So,
Freight.
I think I'll just continue the stretching and kind of pucker slightly at the bottom. So let's continue the stretch effect while making it look like... kind of looks like a, well, I won't say what it looks like, but I'll try not to suggest that shape too much, but that's kind of where we're going with it. Maybe I should do this, maybe I should do something else. Here we go, kind of make it look like that, make the hair start to unravel a little bit, so it doesn't look too much like a nutsack. There we go. Now I think the next frame he starts to say the A sound.
Great. Prated.
Oh, well, he's still kind of saying the er sound.
Prayed. What if we prayed?
But I think if I start doing the A sound in this frame, it will look good. I think it'll still work, just because of the way it plays. But let's see. Let's try it. So we're going to stretch the mustache out to indicate that the mouth is going outward, and we want it to have kind of a smiley look. So create the big shape, do the little shapes. Missing a strand, so let's do it that way. Let's add one there. Now, to get the effect, we need to do the frame after it too, otherwise it won't be able to really see if it's working. So since he said the big A there, and he's moving backward, and the A is kind of going to start resting, so we gotta slowly bring the shape down. It moved down to the left anyway, so that's obviously going to do that, but we're also going to start drooping the mustache a little bit. Now, this frame is going to be the one he rests on, so we can't keep adding the mustache on that layer. So I'm going to lock that layer again. And, well, I can't lock it because the onion skin won't show. So I gotta be careful, make sure I'm on the second pencil layer. And we'll start making it lower a bit more. Right. That may still be a little too much, but let's see. Let's see how it looks.
What if we prayed it into our? What if we prayed it into? Prayed it into.
It kind of looks like the A is too late.
Prayed it into our. If we prayed it into our mouth.
All right, let me. I don't mind hearing the voice because we got to hear where it is, but.
Prayed it. Didn't. Did it.
Okay, the D for prayed is going to be at that frame, so we'll put that there.
Prayed it. Prayed.
Something about it doesn't look right. I don't know. Something about it doesn't look right.
What if we pray? What if we prayed it in?
Okay, yeah, the problem here is that he's moving backward. He's moving down and backward, but the mustache is moving too solidly with him. Oops, dang it, no, that's correct, that's okay. Okay, the mustache should not move with him in totality, it should be pulled, because it has no, well, it's not moving on its own. So it's moving down to the left, but it needs to still be pulled from where it came from. So I need to kind of let it pull. There we go. Remember that it was being pulled through the air, so it's not going to just come straight down flat. So we needed to stretch it back to where it came from. Stretch it from where it came from, rather. So that doesn't, no, that doesn't look right. There's gotta be another way this way. There, that looks a little better. Because it's showing that it's being pushed down by the air as it's moving downward. And also that curl is not quite right. I don't want it to do too much too soon. Now that I think about it, maybe I should not lower it too much at all. Let's do it this way. Let's keep it at the same height, so it looks like it's really being pushed. Still Well, it's because he's moving left. Maybe that's the problem. Yeah, it's because he's moving down to the left. I need to make it look like it's being pulled from that direction. Oh, hey! Hey, GameZar! Good to see you! Thanks for stopping in. Just a moment here.
Good day, Mr. GameZar. Thank you for joining us. Looks like it's Arts and Crafts Day here at the stream, so I hope you brought your glue stick and some safety scissors. I think there's still some pink construction paper left, so have at it.
How have you been, GameZar? Are you doing okay? This sort of is a Pac-Man ghost. It's from a character made by a friend of mine online named Pac-Billy. He and I are collaborating on a cartoon, and he wrote this scenario with these two characters. Macaroni art? Yeah, have at it. We got a whole shelf full of pasta over here. We got tortelloni, we got rigatoni, we got some tagliatelle. You can make any kind of art you like. But and then that can be part of our cooking video too. But yeah, it's Arts and Crafts Day. I didn't feel like playing. I kind of wanted to. A rough mental health day, but it'll be fine. Trust me, I know exactly what you mean. I really do. I was in a bad mood today, and actually, over the last couple weeks, I was having I was in a bad spot. I wasn't doing good. That's why I didn't stream too much. I was just or do anything really online, just because I was not feeling good. So I understand. But hang in there. It always gets better. The hardest part about that is remembering sometimes that, you know, it gets better. There's always a dawn, and that's the hard part. But it always gets better. I feel like I kind of bounced back from it, and I'm sure you will too. But so today is kind of like my art therapy. We're just doing some work on a project that I need to keep working on. Poor Pac-Billy, he presented this project to me. Oh, excuse me just a second. Oh. Okay, sorry about that. He presented this project to me, God, almost 2 years ago now, and I feel terrible because I'm plodding through it, and I'm going so slow. I mean, animation's a slow process to begin with, but I have a hard time with it. I want to work on this, and it's great when things work out, but at the same time, it's like, sometimes I don't like the way it works out. Or I get stuck on what exactly I want it to look like. He's been great, though. Pac-Billy's been very, very understanding and patient with me. And he doesn't like something, he's very, very cautious and careful, and he doesn't want to hurt my feelings, because they're not doing this for money, we're just doing this for fun. But he does want to try and submit this to an animation festival. And I don't know, I don't want to let him down. He also thought maybe he could help motivate me by doing like a Kickstarter kind of thing, where like, you know, we might get some money or donations to try and get it done. But I'm like, no, if I do that, then I'll be having even more people expecting stuff from me, and it'll paralyze me further. But it was a kind gesture. It was very thoughtful. He's a good guy. So I'm trying to do my best by him. You know what, since it's just the two of us, maybe I'll show you what we've got so far. Oh wait, I can't show it to you here in Flash, but I can show you. Let me see if I can show you something else here. I'd have to show you piece by piece, but how do I do that? Maybe I can do a display capture? Let's see here. Let me see. Display capture, where is it? Display capture. Oh, wait a minute. I could try this. Okay, yeah. I don't usually like showing too much on my desktop, but I don't think it's a problem. Let me see if this works. Not that one. That's not it.
What is this? If you give me a hint or something. Look, I can't give you a hint.
What's going on?
It's the only thing here to see.
Where's the first one? Oh, that's why. That's why. Okay. All right. That's because it didn't have a number. Okay. Are you there, GameZar? Can you hear me? I'd like to show it to you, but I don't want to show it to you if I don't want to start playing it if you're not there to see. Just let me know if you're there. Okay, cool. Are you ready? I'll play the clips that we've done so far. Cool. Thank you. All right, I'll play you the clips that I've done so far, and you can see what it's all about. Here we go.
So, what's going on here?
Oh, it's you. Someone I've never met. You see that burrito over there?
Could you be more specific?
You know that burrito right there. The only burrito. The only burrito that's there. Do you see that one?
The one to the left of that one?
No, that one. The only burrito that's there.
I think I see it. I'm squinting. Wait. My eyes are all the way closed. Oh, okay, that's better. Now I see it. Sure. It's blue, right?
Yes. No. It's just ordinary burrito color.
Maybe.
Hold on. Okay, there's more. I just forgot I was muted. Hang on a second.
Maybe if you give me a hint or something.
Look, I can't give you a hint. It's the only burrito. It's the only thing here to see. It's just you, me, and this only burrito.
Wait, it's coming in. I think I see it. To view here. Is this it? Is this it? No, that's a different burrito wearing a fake mustache.
There aren't any mustachioed burritos. There's just the one burrito, and it isn't blue, and it doesn't have any facial hair. Are you an imbecile?
Yes, actually, I'm quite an accomplished imbecile.
Well, at any rate, there's a burrito hair. Are you an imbecile?
Yes, actually, I'm quite an accomplished imbecile.
Well, at any rate, there's a burrito directly in front of us, and I'm rather famished, so I'm trying to let it get into my mouth, you see.
If you say so. You know, I'm kind of hungry myself.
Well, you don't say. There's plenty of burrito to go round, as you can plainly not see for some reason.
Oh, wait a minute.
Directly in front of us, and I'm rather famished, so I'm trying to let it get into my mouth, you see.
If you say so. You know, I'm kind of hungry myself.
Well, you don't say. There's plenty of burrito to go round, as you can plainly not see for some reason.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait, you said it was the only burrito? Yes, of course I see it. It's always the last place you look, isn't it?
I'm really peckish, you know. I haven't eaten in days. And here's this burrito on the outside of my mouth.
Of course I see it. It's always the last place you look, isn't it?
I'm really peckish, you know. I haven't eaten in days. And here's this burrito on the outside of my mouth. Where we are. And I'm trying to let it get into the inside of my mouth. If you would care to join me, we can both set about the business of letting it get into each of our respective mouths.
This isn't working. No matter how hard I let it get into my mouth, it keeps being out here on the outside of my mouth with us.
What do you mean? I really think toward the end there it was really just about to let loose and get right in all the way inside of my mouth.
You know, this may sound crazy, but what if instead of letting it get into our mouths, we took things one step further?
Get right in all the way inside of my mouth.
You know, this may sound crazy, but what if instead of letting it get into our mouths, we took things one step further and needed it to get into our mouth?
That's so daft, it just might work. Let's begin. This isn't working. I'm needing it really bad, you know, to get in there, but it's not getting into it. It's not even next to it.
You know, I think it might be a little closer to my mouth, actually. I'm not very good with dead reckoning, but...
Of course you're not good with dead reckoning. You couldn't even see it.
I think that whole time I was accidentally needing it to stay out here with us.
A common beginner's mistake. Why, I remember when I first started needing it to get into my mouth.
Wait, I've got it.
Okay, sorry about that. I was muted again. Sorry about that. That's all I got so far. Hi there, Double. Thanks for showing up. Sorry about the muting there. My dog is barking at me, so I gotta take him out, but I just want to explain. That's as far as I've gotten so far. The shot that I'm working on is the one immediately after that last one. Parkers. And but I do need to take care of him. Yeah, this is an animation I'm working on. It's a project I'm working on, with collaborating on with a friend of mine online, a guy named Pac Billy. I don't know if you've heard of him or not, but he's really funny and he's very talented. He wrote this scenario and designed these characters, and he asked if I would help him make it. It's not like a paid project or anything. It's just for fun. It's just a hobby. But he thought he might submit it to an animation festival after it was done. He's submitted some stuff to animation festivals in the past, and he wanted to do this. So that's his voice, it's his script and all that stuff. I'm just animating it, and I'm trying to do the best I can. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm going to do some work on it in a minute, and so you can see what I'm working on. But again, the dog is bugging me, so let me take care of him. I know, Parker. I'll take care of him, and then I shall return. Just a moment. Okay, we're back. Alright. So, we're gonna get back to it here. Let me put on a little music. Okay. But it's nice of you guys to stop in. I hope you guys are doing okay. Hope you won't be disappointed that we're not doing games today. I might do some games later, but right now I just wanna... It's been a while too long since I worked on this, and I need to do something productive. I've had kind of a... annoying couple days, and I've just been... some people just really annoy me. Especially online. Let me warn you, don't get embroiled in internet conversations about serious topics. It'll drive you crazy. I guess I probably don't have to tell you guys that, but still. It's a lesson I've learned multiple times, and I keep thinking that as long as the topic is something that you think you have, there's no alternate position on. You still sometimes will encounter people who will fight you, and it makes no sense. All right, anyways, but that got me into a really bad mood, so I'm trying to chill out here. But anyway, how are you guys doing? Enough negative stuff. Are you guys doing okay? character is... What's going on with this shot is the character is moving from one pose where he's looking down, he says a couple words, and then he tilts down and goes upward to the second pose. But because his mustache is so flexible and pliable, it kind of needs to stretch and pull down in a way that's believable. It's not supposed to look stiff. Okay, I totally get the bad mood. I skipped my strange news in a foul mood. Oh, I understand. I'm sorry. Yeah. Do you feel like talking about it? You can talk about what's on your mind if you want. If it's really personal, private, no problem. But who knows? We might have some input on it. All good, thanks, please, ZX81. Or is it ZX81? I apologize. You have to forgive me. I was born in 1980, I was never had any PCs. I never had any personal computers growing up. So I'm not familiar with all of them. Is that an Atari system? The ZX81? My baseline is bad mood. Well, in a way, that's not necessarily a bad thing. It just means that there's nowhere to go but up.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
Oops, put some of that in the wrong... That's the problem here. When I have that, I have to keep that layer unlocked so I can view it in the onion skin. But, that means I might accidentally draw on that layer. Oh, it's a Sinclair system. Oh, okay. Oh, no, so trigger, I'm saying. That's okay, no problem. I understand. Timex in the States, huh. Oops. Oh, wait a minute. I thought I had this on shuffle. Oh, I might have on repeat. Let's shuffle this area. Oh, that's fine. There we go. There, that's better. Alright. Your daughter does animation. Oh, really? That's cool. I mean, is she... Does it a hobby, or is it something she does professionally? I think I might have made a mistake here. I think I did this in the wrong. Okay, well, I think I can lock this layer again, so... I know, I'm gonna get a copyright strike. Well, not a strike, but a copyright warning, but... My stream is so small, nobody cares. Yeah, I love Alan Parsons Project. Kind of rushing through this and fudging it, but it might work. Oh, she's studying it right now. Wonderful. Good for her. Though she's probably doing 3D animation or 3D rendering animation, which I have no clue about. I've always ever just drawn by hand. I've always just done 2D. In this particular animation, I'm not really using a lot of the principles for this particular animation because the shape is so easy and so easy to work with that I can just play with it. But the trick is to just kind of understand how it would move in relation to this, the rest of the character. Because the character is moving his body, and the mustache is moving to demonstrate how his kind of... The mouths are covered, so the mustache has to do the expression. It has to do the you know, kind of move the way that your mouth would move. Like, if he says a P sound, it would, like, a puh sound, it would, like, I made it, like, puff inward. And if it's a large expressive vowel, like the A in parade here, it goes outward. And then kind of, but because he's moving downward, I still need to kind of show that the mustache is thick and bushy and will be pushed up by the air. So I kind of have to see that shape there.
What if we prayed it into our...
Okay, that's looking good. It's a little better. I gotta get a couple more frames. But...
Didn't.
But I also have... He says, starting to say the next word.
Didn't.
So, while it can... It might look okay if it droops, I need it to start moving again for the next few words.
What if we prayed it into our... Didn't.
So... I probably...
Didn't.
It. I probably... Prayed it. I could should probably start here, actually. Probably start doing the next word here.
What if we prayed it in?
Expressions of the eyes and eyebrows, yeah. Okay, well, okay. He's saying it, so... I could probably stretch it out laterally. Let's see how that looks for the it. Because you think about how you move your mouth and you say the word it. It. I mean, but do it in an exaggerated way. How would you, like, it? So let's have it go outward like that. Let's see how it goes. We'll start with the major shape. We always start with the major shape of it to try to get the idea of the overall motion, and then you put the little shapes. Four. Now it's kind of a jump. You know, from this motion, the falling motion here. It's falling down, falling, and then that. But that's meant to show that the speech is more important than the gravity. The speech pulls it more than the gravity does. So, it's not realistic, but I think it's visually pleasing.
Into.
So then he immediately goes from it into prayed it.
Into. It in. Ate it into.
It might be a little late. Let's see how late.
Prayed it into.
Well, that might work. But now I'm thinking it might just be better if it just goes straight into the word into. Let me see. But let's try that. In.
Into arm. Into arm. Into arm. Into arm.
Okay, that's where the T sound comes in. That's and so the T sound will be there. So we're going to use the next two frames to kind of relax this. Because he's saying in. And as you say the word in, your mouth kind of moves inward. It kind of closes again. So we're going to pull them. We're going to relax this in the next two frames. And by relax, I just mean it's going to fall a little bit. So move it down. Make sure this line is a little lower than that line. And pull that down. And move that a little down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then it's going to relax a little more in the next one. We'll just bring it down and then kind of bring it down like that. And then give it a little looseness. Well, maybe not too much. I don't want it to look too stiff. I want it to look a little flowy. And I'm kind of fudging at times, I'll admit that, because the animation is sometimes so quick. Little details won't be noticeable. You mostly just want to get that big shape. You want to get the... As long as the big shape, the big motion is visible, the little ones don't always have to be perfect. I mean, I'm trying to tell myself that, because if I get too perfectionistic, I will never get any work done. Hold on, I gotta erase this dot here. It'll just confuse me otherwise. There we go.
Fade it into... It into arm.
I don't like that. Hey! It's Lucas Boy! Hey, guys. Hey, I'm just a sec. Just a second here.
Greetings. We are animating here today, Mr. Lucas Boy. Drawing by hand, just as the great Preston Blair and Bob Clampett once did. Nowadays, it's all done with 3D modeling, something I've never much appreciated, though mostly that's because it's too damn complicated to learn. And I'm certainly not about to ask someone to wear one of those ridiculous ball-spangled mocap suits.
How you doing, Lucas Boy? Thanks for stopping in. I've wanted to do a little bit of animating today because it's just been a while, and I was kind of in a grumpy mood, so I'm like, I need to do something positive. So hope you don't mind a little break from gaming today. We're gonna get back to this. Hope Pac Billy's not too mad at me because I haven't been working on this in a while, and I feel bad. I don't want to. I've always been bad about long-term projects. I get into these creative gusts where I just really want to work and work and work, and then there's just days, times when I just can't work at all. I get frustrated, or I don't like how it's turning out, and I can't look at it. And it's not, I mean, it's not good. It's not something, it means I have a hard time working consistently, and it's not something I'm proud of. My wife thinks I have ADHD, but...
What if we prayed it into our...
Okay, that kind of looks all right. But as you can see, Lucas Boy, this is another character saying this phrase. And the shot I'm working on, he's starting in one pose and then moving up into a second pose as a way of like kind of like, wow, what if we did this? You know, kind of a wow expression. But the mustache has to move with the body in a believable way, or a pleasant, believable way. And I got to make sure that it moves properly as he says the next few words. As he stands in this pose, he's not going to move, so the mustache is going to move along. But I got to make sure it works right. And I don't think that this is giving the effect that I quite wanted. Maybe it's the positioning. Let's see. Maybe if I move it up in a little bit. Well, maybe not that. Maybe it's the way I'm making it rest too much. Let me try this. Well, let's put that... Maybe we should put that back. And maybe it's this one. I think maybe it's that. It's like... No, I think that is the offending frame. That frame doesn't look right. See, there's something I don't like about that. Maybe it's not a dramatic enough motion? It doesn't look like it's going from one... jumping from one movement to the other in a way that I really... that's satisfying to me. Of course, this frame could be a problem, too. So I'm gonna make an adjustment to this one. Hold on a second here. Okay. Let's pull this down a little bit more for dramatic movement. Okay, and then this is where he goes to the next word, where he says he says it, but I kind of want it, I want it to have a satisfying outward jump, because he's saying it, and if you say the word it in a very exaggerated way, your mouth goes sideways, so I want it to look like the mustache is jumping out sideways. And because this is an exaggerated cartoon, you can kind of get away with anything like this. Okay, but we gotta get the main shape right. That's the key here. So maybe I should, but... You know what? Yeah, let's just do the major shape. And then, because it's...
Into our map.
And then I was going to have it pull back in, retract a little bit in the next two frames. But when I tried that, it didn't look quite right. So maybe I need to focus more on the lateral motion than the downward motion. Let's just do the big shape, and then we'll do the little shapes. Okay, let's see how that looks.
We prayed it into our...
Okay, well, what I think we need to do is move this frame in. We gotta... I think it's off to a good start there. Let me, I need to stretch that out. One. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think that looks all right. In. And then it's pulling in, and then he says, to our mouths, to.
Into our mouths.
He's still in the middle of the N and T sound. It's like in the middle.
Into our...
But I think if I make the next motion now, it might turn out okay. It might... Otherwise, it would be too... might look too late. That's the problem when you only have 24 frames a second to work with. You kind of have to... fudge it a little bit at times. At least in my experience. I'm going to start with an exaggerated ooh sound. When I do an ooh sound for this guy, I usually do like move, I pull the mustache down like this, like ooh. And we'll start exaggerated. Like the whole mustache is being pulled down with his lips, like his lower lip is pulling it downward. I don't know, I know it's probably not how real mouths work, but it seems to get the point across. It seems to communicate it right in this one.
Tour.
And then, because the sound is continuing here, I'll just retract it slightly.
To our mouth.
Okay, and then he's saying our. So, okay. Well, let's see how this looks, okay.
Prayed it into our mouth.
Yeah, there we go.
Prayed it into our mouth.
Yeah, by doing it early, it still worked out okay.
If we prayed it into our mouth.
Okay, so,
To our mouth.
And this frame, he's still saying ooh, and then this...
To our mouth.
But, then he starts saying our. To our. So, it's a two different sounds, so... I'm gonna have to move the mustache again. I think splitting it, having two frames between each keyframe tends to work pretty well, but if you do three, it starts to look choppy. If I did all 24 frames every single time, it would not work. It would take me forever, so I kind of do every other frame, unless it has to be for effect. It has to, like, they're here, you'll see a couple of, frames that are like one frame apart.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
But for the most part, 12 frames a second works. But sometimes you need to have 24.
To our mouth.
I'm still just thinking what would be the best way to go. To our. Well, maybe, because I don't want to do the same motion twice. So our. Would it be, let's do some outward. Like it's going outward. Very exaggerated at first, and we'll see how it looks. Very exaggerated. And then... and then pull it back, retract it slightly. What am I doing? Yeah, there we go. Pull it back in. Then
our mouth.
Well, let me see where the mouth starts.
Mouth.
So I think the M sound's gonna start there, so we're gonna keep retracting with the hour here until we get to that. I think saying the word hour is just one motion. You don't have to say animate the er. Let's watch the whole thing and see how it looks here.
Ate it into our mouth.
Yeah, there we go.
To our mouth.
Yeah. It stretches out, and we're gonna make the little bristles far apart at first and thin, and then they'll fatten up as they pull back in. And then he's going to say mouths, so we're going to start with an M sound here.
Mouth.
So, to get that effect of the pursed lips that you use when you say the M sound, I'm going to puff up the mustache again and kind of pull it in like this. Just go... look like it's like he's stuffing his own mouth with his mustache. Mouths is all going to be just one motion. It's going to be mouths. So it's going to pop back out for the O sound. Mouths. It's probably going to be for an ow sound. I mean, it's the same as our. So we're probably going to do something similar to the last one. Like this, where it was like our. And then mouths. So, but I don't want to read. Well, I might be able to get away with duplicating it, but I don't want to. And the mustaches are so easy to draw. It's might as well just go for it. Just go. We'll do it, take it a little bit further. Just go like that. Actually, let's point that outward a little bit more. There we go. Okay, now it's all just a relaxation. Just mouths, so it's all just going to be the mustache is just going to retract in until in a slow, gentle manner, and we'll probably give it maybe 3 or 4 frames to do so. 4 is pretty good, but if it needs more, we'll give it more. Whoops, pull it in a little bit more. And a little bit more. A little bit, but not too much. We don't want to jump too much at this point because it's the motion's going to be, it's going to ease. It's going to ease a little bit, so make it the motion a little lighter at this point. A little teeny bit. Then even teenier. Almost imperceptible. There we go. And so let's see how it looks.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
Prayed it. There we go.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
All right, that looks pretty good. I'm happy with that. Now, the other character is going to speak, but first I want to ink this. Ink and paint it. Well, I don't know. I wonder if I should ink and paint it or not, because I want to run it by Pac Billy before I... Maybe I should run it by him. But then again, it might look better in ink and paint, so an ink and painting is not really as much fun as watching the animation itself. It's so I might just leave it in pencil for now. What do you guys think? If you're still there. you think I should ink and paint it now? That is to say, you know, put the black outline, fill it in, and to get the final result, or should I just leave it in pencil for now and move on to the next one?
What if we prayed it into our mouth? Prayed it into our mouth, eh?
So the other character's gonna start talking at this.
Well, prayed. Prayed it. Prayed it. Prayed it.
Where is he? He starts saying it here, but it's hard to tell. Maybe I should, that's the burrito. So Commodore. Okay. All right. Yeah, I like the way that looks. I say ink it. Well, it's not really about the process, Lucas Boy. I understand what you're saying. It's more about whether it's worth doing or not, because if Pac-Billy's not cool with it, it'll be like wasted work. But at the same time, I think it might be more impressive to share if it's inked and painted, and because you can see the final result instead of just a rough pencil sketch. So it's a trait. I like to ink and paint it, but I also think it's kind of boring to watch because... But I can show it to you. I can just do a little bit of it. So, I have two things. Okay, there's only one frame on this layer that I need to do. the hard part is the hands. The hands and the mustache have to be done on a separate layer. So, how do I want to do this? I'm trying to think out the best way to do this. Because the hands are static, but the mustache is moving, but the mustache is below the hands. So the hands have to be on the higher layer. So, alright, no, we don't need to work on it. We need to work on this one here. This. Okay, this is... I'm gonna lock that. That's the ink. Oh, it's already like this. Okay, I don't need to add a keyframe here. And I only added that as a guide for the bottom, so I will... That. Will it only work on this layer? Yes. Okay, good. Gotta lock the pencil one, too, so I don't want to mess with that. Oops. Something's wrong. Something's wrong. Yep, I deleted that one. I didn't mean to. That's why. Okay. There we go. Then I'll delete that one. Alright, this music sounds a little loud. Is the music too loud? Is it covering me up? Is it distracting? I like to have some background sound because it's pretty boring without it, but... It helps me to focus. But I don't want it to be too loud or too quiet. Let me turn this down just a teeny bit. There we go. Oh, good. Thank you, Lucas Boy. I appreciate it. Okay. So the two main things we need to think about here are the hands and the mustache. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go on the additional... additional layer, and we are going to trying to plan this out, make sure that I don't screw it up. So we're going to go on the second layer, additional layer, which is like the what I call it for stuff that has to move separately from the main layer, and I'm going to draw the arms here, but they also have to be on the main layer, so that's the tricky part. Let's see what I think I will do to keep it cohesive, is I will go in the main ink layer, erase this, and draw them on the main layer. Okay. There we go. Hand is in front of his nose here. Gotta get rid of that. Okay. And, okay. Sometimes drawing these long curving lines is tough. It's easy if it's in pencil because you can kind of rough it. But when it's in ink, you gotta do it in one go. So, we're going to use this as a guide. Copy this and paste it on the additional layer. But we're not going to use all of that. I'm just going to use a little bit of it. Let's lock that. I'm going to erase this, but you'll still see it because it's on the lower layer. Okay. And then, if you hide the ink layer, we just have the hands and the nose there. This is the layer we're going to use to ink the mustache. We put the hands on the ink layer just for reference, so that way when we draw the rest of the body, we can fill it in without any gaps, or hopefully without any gaps. So now what we need to do is, because we're looking at let's look at the way the mustache moves. The mustache is going to move up there, it's going to move up there. It's going to be covered up by the hands in many places, but it does still intersect those lines. So I need to be sure that it's covered by the right colors. So the nose does not need to be filled in. Well, it actually, there's a line that needs to be added there. Hold on. I haven't drawn it. But for cohesion, let's do this. I'm going to have to draw that the edge of the nose there. Ink, okay. There we go. And, no, I think it's okay. Alright, let's take that line, paste it up here. Oh, did I grab everything again? I think I did. I don't need everything. I just want to keep it simple here. Okay, mono-additional. Yeah, ink is locked. Okay. So now we just have the parts we really need to make sure that the motion is visible, but... Okay. So what we need to do now is get the orange color from the previous frame. There's the orange color. Let's hide that again. And I'm going to fill this in so that... There we go. Now we're going to fill it in on the ink layer below as well, so all the rest of the stuff will still be there. Alright, I think we're ready to start. What we need to do now is before we start doing the mustache, we need to make sure we set up the keyframes. So that way this setup here that we have with the arms will stay, and we don't have to draw it every time, or paste it back in every time. Okay, and then on this frame we can get rid of it, because it's going to be gone after on that one. Then we're going to put it and start another one there, because the mustache will be have its own layer
into
there.
Our map.
So, okay. That was a little tricky, but we got it. Now, on this layer, however, we'll have to create new keyframes. So, get rid of that. And then we'll put that, and that. Then we got keyframes for all of those. And... we're not going to make these keyframes yet because we might need the nose there. So, okay. I'm looking ahead a little bit. I'm kind of looking all over the place, but I think we're going to need to be. So let's lock the ink one because we don't want to draw on that by accident. And I think we're ready to start drawing the mustache. Inking the mustache, rather. Okay, the mustache is in red because it's moving on. It's a separate object. I wanted to make sure it was distinctive from the others. Grab that color from the previous shot again. Oops, I forgot this frame. Okay, no biggie. Let's fill this one. There we go. Okay. Let's do this one. Black, right? Okay. There we go. Well, it's a little off, but I think it works because of the curvature of the body there. It's probably better that way. Filling it in. Actually, I think I will just do the inking first and then fill it in, and come back and fill it in. Puffed up motion there. I think it's meant to be like this. There we go. Okay. Puff there. Spreads out again. Okay, then it relaxes again. Now we're going into these movements. Let's fill in the. Let's do the fills first. There's a gap. There it is. This is my least favorite part about inking and painting, is finding the gaps. There we go. Yeah, I guess it was there. Sometimes it can be so minuscule. There's an option for the fill tool to close gaps. Like if there's a tiny gap, it will still fill, but it will just close it. But sometimes it does it when you don't want it to. So it's not particularly trustworthy. Okay, so now we've got the must. Whoop, I feel like there's a. Was there, yeah, there's a spot I missed here. Here we go. And here. Oops. Oh, I don't like that there. Let me fix that. There we go. Okay, now I gotta do the main pose. I need to ink that. Pose is not going to have the mustache on it. It's just going to have the head, the eyes, and the nose. But I've already drew those, so I don't have to draw them again. Okay, this part is tricky because it's hard to get the curve of the head right. It always ends up kind of bumpy. Well, that looks okay. That looks alright. That worked out all right. filling. Oh, I could just do it this way. There we go.
What if we prayed?
Okay. There's a gap there that I, or a spot here I didn't fill in on that level, on that layer. Oops. If it's all selected and you change the color, it'll change the color of everything. There we go. There we go. So, we're going to start working on the next one now. The next motion. One of the whole body's moving up. Okay. Now, the mustache is in red, but there's no two layers here. It's all happening on one layer. The mustache is just there for distinction. Just to make it distinct from the rest of the body. But hopefully it should not cause too much confusion. I gotta remember that as long as I just remember that the hands are in front. Well, I could just erase stuff because we're don't have to worry about that now. We're drawing through. Whoops. Forgot. I gotta do it that way. Well, you know what? Fuck it. Oh, we'll be alright. We can do it. Let's do it this way. Okay, we've got a lot to work with here. Hands are still in front, so we gotta draw those first. Up to that point is okay, there we go. Dipping forward. Oops. No, kind of. Yeah, I think it'll be okay. Now, let's just draw the mustache behind it. Okay. Alright. Now I have to do the hard part of drawing the long, curvy lines. Started off all right though. There we go. It did that weird shit. It's a weird glitch where it like makes it, it tries to smooth it even though I didn't want it to. It looks okay though. Hands are still in front, but I accidentally erased a section of it, but I think we can make it reconnect it. There we go. Okay, there we go. Yeah, we can do that next part, yeah. Okay, just keep it. Keep it slow, take it slow. There we go. Let's do the mustache now. Okay. All right. Pull it back down a little bit. Oops. One problem that I have when I animate, I find that as I tend to shrink things, like the eyes here, they start off large, and as I animate them, as the animation goes forward, I find that I start making them too small. They get smaller and smaller in proportion with everything else. So I've got to be careful about that. Sometimes that's okay if you're doing like a squash and stretch effect, but that wasn't what I was going for. There we go. Oh, there's a line that needs to be included. Oh, I didn't do the mustache here either. Here we go. Well, that's okay. That's okay. He's pitched downward. Okay. All right. Again, hands are in front. Start with those. Oops. Screwed that up there. Dang it. Didn't connect it right. Still not quite right. Yeah, that's a little better. Okay. There we go. No, that kind of fell off the line there. Let's try it again. There we go. Come on, baby. There we go. Hands. Gotta do the hands. Again. There we go. I don't really like. Oh, it smoothed it again. Dang it. Hate when it does that. Because then it ruins the thickness of the line. And I'm trying to avoid having varied thicknesses of the line, so it doesn't look good in animation, I find. It's disruptive. Paintings or drawings, you know, it looks good. But, to have varied thicknesses as you draw a single stroke, but in animation I find it doesn't look good because it's next impossible to maintain thicknesses between frames. At least for me. Hands are front, so. there. All right. Okay, then the nose and mustache are in front. He's stretching upward, so the bottom is just pulling in a little bit. It's like, but I don't think that, oh, I don't like the way that looks. The pencil was, I think I rushed the pencil. So let's try to correct that by looking back at this. Yeah, okay, I think that kind of gets it across, but I don't know, I don't like that concave look. Let's try to make it just keep the same shape. Okay, and No, I like that long, narrow shape it has. I don't want to mess it up. There we go. Okay. Now my tablet has a weird problem. At a certain position, horizontal position on it, it like has a bump, and it'll bump my lines around. So I gotta move. I can't draw on that area, so I gotta scroll a little bit to avoid that. Most tedious part of the process, but this is as important as the rest. Oops. Yeah, that looks alright. It's gotta be. Yeah, that's more sensible. Okay. Okay. Let's get the other hand. I need to be more thorough with the pencil. And so professional animators would have cleanup artists. They'd go through all the pencil frames that the animators would draw. They're usually extremely rough and messy, and clean them up. So the inkers and painters could have an easier time redrawing over it. My crew is on vacation. All my cleanup artists are gone. There, he's resting. Starting to move back down. He's resting again, so the slime at the bottom is going to settle back down. That doesn't look good. If it's going down, it should not go in. It's easy to get sloppy in the pencil phase without thinking about how it will turn out in the ink phase. looks a little better. Oops. I want him to go inward that way. That's a little better. If that's the case, then that doesn't look good either. So this has to be fixed. There we go. Now it looks like he's staring off in the distance rather than something more off to the side. I kind of like the idea of him looking like at something that isn't there for this expression. Alright. Alright. The bristles are in the front now. Okay. Yeah, that's better. Yeah, that looks good. Scroll it down. A little too far. Hands again. There we go. That was good. Really get the Commodore out of there because he's in the way, but I think I got the shape down. Okay, bristles again. There we go. Okay, good, good. Next, okay, we're getting there, we're getting there. Oh, is this the one? Yeah, this is. I should not be drawing the mustache. I gotta be careful. Not on this pose, not on this frame. That's gonna go on the additional layer. It's no big deal, this is just one frame. Okay. Right now we're just gonna draw through it, because the mustache is gonna move again over it for the speech, so we need to make sure that this body is intact here. Started off okay. Nope, nope. Might work if we can connect it better. It's harder than it seems to use these tablets like this, because I'll admit, the calibration on it is not perfect. No matter how many times I calibrate it, I can't seem to get it to touch one-to-one every time. But I can adjust for it at times. But not always. Ooh, I kind of like that, but let's... There, yeah. But again, this needs to come out, since we got it there. Okay. There. I like that. That looks good. Okay. bring this eyebrow down slightly. There we go. I like that. I like that. Okay, gotta connect this. This is tricky. Alright, that looks good. Doing that arc of the top of the head is always tricky, because it's very hard to do. It still doesn't look quite right, but I can get it, I can get it. There we go. Okay, alright, so we got those poses inked. We just gotta paint them in now. No radiation today? Oh! Oh, okay. Well, the machine is broken. That's not good to hear. Sheesh. How is your dad doing? He's doing all right? It's not going to be a problem that he can't go today, is it? Okay. Whites of the eyes. He's annoying. Oh, I bet. Ugh. So you guys gonna go out and do something else instead with your free time? Oops, wrong color. What's going on here? Oh, that's why. Okay, there we go. Hope not. Sitting down is pretty good. I know, it's how I feel. I kind of want to do the same thing this weekend, but my mother-in-law has some stuff she needs to take care of at her house. My wife's grandpa is in the hospital, and he never really took good care of himself in the house, and he smoked a lot, so he had a lot. So it's gotten to the point where the walls are just practically dripping with nicotine stains. It's really disgusting. So now that he's out of there, he's so stubborn, he wouldn't let anybody clean his stuff. And he would say that the cleaners, the cleanser smell would bother his lungs. It's like, yeah, okay, the nicotine's fine, but the cleansers are bad. But anyway, now that he's out of there, he's in the hospital. Obviously, with these issues that he's got to stop smoking. But he's out of the way, so we're cleaning the hell out of his space in the house, so we'll probably be going over there and doing some wall scrubbing, ceiling scrubbing, and some more dusting and stuff. Where is the gap on this thing? Oh, there it is. I think I spotted it. There we go. That's the last pose. Okay. So yeah, it's going to look like that on this layer. And then we're going to draw over on the layer above it. But we got to copy and paste the nose onto it. Oh, it's locked. Okay, don't forget to do that. There we go. So now we've got a nose on that layer. So we can draw the mustache. Now that we have the nose on that layer, we can add the other keyframes. So let's see that. Okay. So now we've added the other keyframes. It'll make a huge difference very quickly. What do you mean, cleaning the house? Or did you mean something else? Like our cleaning the house, getting the nicotine off the walls? Because the whole house smelled terrible. Even the pets were starting to cough. Yeah, scraping the walls, yeah. It's gross. It's, even his, my in-laws just basically said, gave up on the bathroom. I don't know why he smokes in the bathroom, but it is even worse in there than it is in his bedroom. It's a disaster. They just said, no, we're just going to remodel it. We're going to rip everything out and replace it. You know, you might be right. Maybe that's not nicotine on the walls after all. Ugh. I don't like how I did that. Try that again. There we go. Oh, this one goes below the hand there. That's not good. Well, it's not a difficult problem to solve. Let's just, if I draw over it again, it won't match right, so I gotta open this up, take a little bit of this. Take a sample from that layer. Rid of that orange on the outside there. And there we go. We can leave that as is. That's right on the edge there. It's not quite as good as it could have been, but that's okay. Ugh. I'm trying to hold this thing right. I'm going to hold it right. There we go. Don't want to go too far off the line. There we go. I don't like that. I don't like that. Dang it. There. And it looks like it intersects with the rest of the arm in the next frame, but no others. Right there. So we'll have to do it again, but just a little different space. Okay, let's lasso this stuff here. Oops, oh, it's locked. Okay. Lasso this stuff here. Copy that. Paste it. Now that I think about it, I don't think I really even needed the color here either, as long as it's... Yeah, as long as it's not cutting into the hand, that's an important thing. The color doesn't really need to be there. It needed to be there for other parts when I needed to draw through, but it's okay. No, I could probably get rid of it, but it don't matter. Oh, I skipped one. I missed one. Okay, well, let's grab this, go back here, paste it in, and we'll... Oops. Alright, well, we got rid of the unnecessary mustache, but we still got the hand, and then we're just gonna draw that back in. The mustache animation reminds me of a Tom and Jerry cartoon. Which one? I know I've seen cartoons where the character's mustache just flips like that. Flips and flops and shoots all over the place. And you never see the mouth, but it gives you the impression that the character's moving the mouth. But I'm not sure which Tom and Jerry cartoon you mean, specifically. Pecos. I'm gonna want to look that up now. I don't know. Give it a shot. I have a browser open. I can Uncle Pecos. Let me see if I can find him. Oh, I see him now. Yeah. I see him. Okay. Let me stop the music. Okay. I can hold on a second here. I've never seen this. This is great, but I love it. Frog went a courtin', he did ride a sword and a revolver by his side. Crambo killed la 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 la. Flop do yellow bug too long. That is great. I love it. Park right in there, and nephew. Crambo killed la la. It's very wispy. You can see how it, like, everything he does, it just kind of flows and. With every motion, it follows it.
And the yodel goes right in there somewhere, but it's a little too high for me. Oh, where will the wedding supper be? Crambo. Where will the wedding supper be? Crambo. Where will the wedding supper be? Way down yonder in a hickory.
This guy's great. The voice actor's terrific.
Crambo killed la 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 la. That's that hard part again, right in there. Scram, flop, a doodle, yellow bug, toodle, on it, didn't come around, top, bottom, and crambo. Guitar string on you, nephew.
That's good. Wow, you're right. You're absolutely right, GamesR. I'd say you nailed it. But yes, that's kind of what I was going for, even though I didn't realize it. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. There you go. Didn't mean to close it. Let's get back to the other one here. Yeah, I like that. It's what I've got going is a little different, but I think it's it's very good animation. The old Tom and Jerry cartoons, their animation's incredible, so good. Now I'm confused about what I'm looking at here. Why do I have this? Let me close that. I have something open here that I don't need open. Okay. Now. Oh, your wife's there to watch? Okay. I'm flattered, but yeah, I'll show you guys. Okay. Let me try to get it from the beginning here, and I'll show you what I've got so far. I need to do full screen here. It's full screen. Here we go.
Let's get out. So, what's going on here? Oh, it's you. Someone I've never met. You see that burrito over there? Could you be more specific? You know that burrito right there. The only burrito. The only burrito that's there. Do you see that one?
The one to the left of that one?
No, that one. The only burrito that's there.
I think I see it. I'm squinting. Wait. My eyes are all the way closed. Oh, okay, that's better. Now I see it. Sure. It's blue, right?
Yes. No. It's just ordinary burrito color.
Maybe if you give me a hint or something.
Look, I can't give you a hint. It's the only burrito. It's the only thing here to see. It's just you, me, and this only burrito.
Wait, it's coming in. I think I see it. I'm squinting. Wait. My eyes are all the way closed. Oh, okay, that's better. Now I see it. Sure. It's blue, right?
Yes. No.
I had a couple takes for some of them because of the, there were some that Pac Billy was like, that's okay, can you make it like this instead? So I might have a couple of repeats, but there's slightly different animations.
To view here, is this it? Is this it? No, that's a different burrito wearing a fake mustache.
There aren't any mustachioed burritos. That's just the one burrito, and it isn't blue, and it doesn't have any facial hair. Are you an imbecile?
Yes, actually, I'm quite an accomplished imbecile.
Well, at any rate, there's a burrito.
Here's another example where I had him looking up into the sky as he's saying it with pride, and Peck Billy was like, can you think you can have him looking towards the camera with his eyes closed? I was like, all right, let's do this.
Yeah. Are you an imbecile?
Yes, actually, I'm quite an accomplished imbecile.
Well, at any rate, there's a burrito directly in front of us. And I'm rather famished, so I'm trying to let it get into my mouth, you see.
If you say so. You know, I'm kind of hungry myself.
Well, you don't say. There's plenty of burrito to go round, as you can plainly not see for some reason.
Oh, wait a minute.
Directly in front of us.
Oops.
And I'm rather famished.
Why do I have another
so
one of these?
I'm trying to let it get into my mouth.
Forget
you
about
see.
This one.
If
there
you say so.
Here.
You know, I'm kind of hungry myself.
Well, you don't say. There's plenty of burrito to go round. As you can plainly not see for some reason.
Oh, wait a minute.
I think I had a slight difference at the end, in the pose at the end. That's probably what's going on there.
Wait, you said it was the only burrito? Yes. Of course I see it. It's always the last place you look, isn't it?
I'm really peckish, you know. I haven't eaten in days. And here's this burrito on the outside of my mouth.
Hold on a second. I'll get to the next row here.
Of course I see it. It's always the last place you look, isn't it?
See, that's another one where the expression was a little bit different.
Where we are, and I'm trying to let it get into the inside of my mouth. If you would care to join me, we can both set about the business of letting it get into each of our respective mouths.
This isn't working. No matter how hard I let it get into my mouth. It keeps being out here on the outside of my mouth with us.
What do you mean? I really think toward the end there it was really just about to let loose and get right in all the way inside of my mouth.
You know, this may sound crazy, but what if instead of letting it get into our mouths, we took things one step further?
Okay, and here's another instance where I had a different action at first. This is the one that Pac Billy said was cool, and this one...
Get right in all the way inside of my mouth.
You know, this may sound crazy.
I did a little twisting animation instead of that one.
And needed it to get into our mouth.
That's so daft it just might work. Let's begin.
Oh.
This isn't working.
I'm needing it really bad, you know, to get in there, but it's not getting into it. It's not even next to it.
You know, I think it might be a little closer to my mouth, actually. I'm not very good with dead reckoning, but...
Of course you're not good with dead reckoning. You couldn't even see it.
I think that whole time I was accidentally needing it to stay out here with us.
A common beginner's mistake. Why, I remember when I first started needing it to get into my mouth.
Wait, I've got it.
And that brings us to where we are now, so... The open mouth sound reminds the little tornado guy from Mathman on Square One. I remember Mathman. I loved Mathman. I used to watch that one. That was one of my favorites. And the voice of Glitch was his name, the tornado, was Jim Thurman, I think his name was. Jim Thurman. And he did all these great voices in those kids' cartoons. I wish I could get a good sample of his voice. Oh, thank you. Well, it's my pleasure, GameZar. It's my pleasure. I'm flattered that you wanted to show it to somebody. Thank you. But that's where I'm at so far. There's still probably about 2 more minutes of animation left to go. I'm notoriously slow about long-term projects because I lose interest, or I get bored, or I get frustrated, and I don't like the way it turns out, so I'm always stopping. I have a hard time working consistently over a long period of time. I get these creative bursts, and then the flame dies. And it's so frustrating because I know Pac-Billy's waiting on this, and he's been so patient, and he's been so nice. So I'm just like... He's been very patient with me. When he makes a suggestion or a note on something, he's always very kind about it. He's never like, nah, that's wrong, that's terrible. He's very gentle and careful about it. I don't necessarily need to be coddled, but when it comes to somebody else's criticisms, because, you know, it's his vision, I'm willing to do what he needs to be done. But he's careful not to discourage me, so I really appreciate him. He's a good guy. So I want to see this through to the end. I don't want to give up on it. But just got to keep at it, even though it can be tedious at times. Here we go here. I'm invested now. I must know where the burrito ends up. I'm not spoiling anything. I'm not spoiling anything. Okay. Fun burrito fact. I got a Tina's burrito to go into my mouth. Tina's burritos rock, man. I love those. Spicy beef and bean, or the red hot beefs are pretty good, too. Love them. GameZar, are you in the UK? I think you are, right? I don't know if you know about Tina's burritos. I don't know if they sell them over there. But they're just microwave burritos. They're pretty damn tasty. I used to eat them all the time. I haven't gotten them lately because my wife's like, we're going to get groceries from now on. So we're getting this like grocery program where they deliver to us every week. Maybe I'll grab a couple one of these days, though. Okay, where was I? I gotta finish filling it. Oh, you're in close, Texas. Yeah, that's close enough. Okay. So I don't know. You probably get really good Mexican food over there. I live in California, in the Central Valley, and there is a large Hispanic community here. And that's by Ireland. No, Lucas Boy, that's Portugal. I'm actually half Mexican myself, so I grew up with Mexican food. I think I told you that story, my mom. Just down the road. Yeah, I'm sure. I live in the Central Valley, so it's more of an agricultural economy. It's not like the big cities. It's a totally different kind of atmosphere, totally different vibe. But the log agriculture, which unfortunately means, you know, we got some braceros out here. But me, I don't know how to make tamales, but my grandma did. Unfortunately, I don't think she passed it on to my mom. I wish she had. So the best we can do is we buy them from mothers at the school that where my wife teaches. There are a lot of Mexican mothers there who will make tamales and give them to her. Or sell them to her. They're often nice enough to give them to her because she's a teacher and she'll teach their kids, so that's her way of thanking them. Okay, let me see. Nothing wrong with that. That's one habit that doesn't harm anyone. Oops. Are you guys green sauce people or red sauce people? Or Christmas? I don't know if they make Christmas tamales. I'm a green sauce person myself, but I don't hate red sauce. I'll take it if it's there. My favorite are pork tamales with green sauce, chili verde in a sense. Or chicken. Whenever I go to a Mexican restaurant, I see if they have a burrito mojado with green sauce and chicken, and that is what I'll get. That is my litmus test for a good Mexican restaurant. Like them dry with chili. The tamales or a burrito? Yeah, I did that video recently, but I don't really like guacamole myself, but I just didn't want it to go to waste. It's too slimy. People always look at me funny in the restaurants when I say I don't like guacamole, and they're like, "You don't like guacamole? What's wrong with you?" But I just don't. Too slimy. Oh, either tamale or burrito. I could probably learn to make tamales. I'd love to do that. Yeah, it's like flavored baby. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. It's flavored baby food, precisely. I just, ugh. My wife loves it. Dad loves it. They say it just adds a creaminess to it. And I'm like, that's exactly what I don't want. I don't want creaminess. Texture is important to me. It's why I don't like onions and bell peppers. I love the flavors they add to foods, and pizza especially. But I hate that crunch. I hate that feeling of biting down into a slice of pizza and there's a crunch of onion or bell peppers. The only crunch I want is in the crust or on a singed piece of pepperoni. Olives and mushrooms, I guess I don't mind that much because they tend to be very tender. Or tomatoes. I don't really love olives. I couldn't just eat them plain, but on a pizza, I don't mind them. Dang it, I'm falling off. Oh, I don't blame you there. No onions on a hamburger. No onions, yuck. But I like tomatoes on hamburgers and sandwiches. My dad, he would just get a dish out of the, he would take a plate out of the cabinet and then just fill it with sliced tomatoes. He'd slice up tomato, put it on the plate, and then just put some salt on them, just eat them like that. Which seems strange to me. I know it's a fruit and all, but, I have to have it on something. I can't eat them plain. Is there a gap in here too? Am I in the right place here? I would have called the cops. Yep. Fruit police. Sorry, sir. We can't allow you to keep this fruit in your house anymore. We're gonna find a foster fruit family for this tomato and give it a new home. What gives? Where's the gap on this one? Yes, George Carlin. Oh, man, the master. The man, the myth, the legend. He's great. He said, "Something has gone afoul inside a tomato. Something is wrong." I agree. It does look like some weird alien embryo. Okay, I don't know where the gap is on that frame. Or this one. Maybe it'll be easier to spot if I just hide the pencil area. There it is. Did you guys see that gap there that I'm filling in right now? I sure didn't at first. Okay, well, here's another obvious one. This one's a little more obvious, but... There we go. Okay, now I gotta get the color back. Oops, no. That's better. Saw a dude eat an onion like an apple once. Oh god. Oh, how awful. It's like that Seinfeld episode when George was saying, I can see just fine without my glasses, and he had just reached into Jerry Seinfeld's refrigerator and pulled out an onion and he started chewing on it. I wonder if that guy started eating the onion by accident and out of fear for his own ego, he just said, you know what, I'm going through with it. I meant to eat this. That dude once that brought sandwiches to work was like a one slice of thick bologna. Ew. One slice of bologna and a giant... Ew. Well, to each their own, I guess, but... Yeah. I imagine that when you say that, I imagine like some kind of deli sandwich. Like, you know how delis will name their sandwiches after people? I wonder who that would be named after. Like, there is a whole, big old thick slice of bologna, big old onion, what a foul. He didn't heat it up in the microwave, did he?
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
I think we're done. I think, you know what, guys? I think we're done with this pose, with this animation. It's all inked and painted.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
There we go. It was pencil before, now it's inked and painted. We got the mustache going.
What if we prayed it into our mouth? What prayed it into our mouth?
Yeah, I think we got it. Oh, we did it. He was a hilarious... Breaths be stankin'. He was an older Hispanic fellow. He was a character.
What if we prayed it into our...
Whoop, I see something off here. Something's off. Yep, there's a problem here. Oh, it's locked. That's why. Okay, there we go. Thanks, Lucas boy. Nice. Bit of effort, but in the end, I'm happy with it. It's always a bit of effort, but...
What if we pray...
Let me see that. I don't know if you should see the mustache do that, or the... No, I think it's okay like that. Let me do a little cleanup here. I don't like that this line is intersecting the nose here. Thanks, GameZar. Appreciate it. And I'll probably stop here now that I've got this little bit accomplished. I'd rather end... Not necessarily end the stream, but just stop animating for now. Feel accomplished rather than try to get too started on something else. There we go. There, that looks a little cleaner. There we go.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
There we go. Yeah, that looks... I like that. I like that. That looks all right.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
Whew, alright. It looks a lot better from a distance, I feel. It's like, when you see it smaller, it's like...
We prayed it into our mouth.
Sometimes when you look at it too close, you get too, like, it's almost like you're invested in it. It's like, you see all the little flaws. Start and finish Ogre Battle. You know, I kind of been wanting to play it again, but I think that I need to say that for a full gaming stream. but I would probably need you to guide me because it's a very complex game. I read through the manual after that day when I played it, and I was like, good lord, you can do so much. You can edit all these different all your units down to the last unit, down to the last man, and you kind of have to consider what you're fighting against and what, you know, whether you're going to be fighting against one thing or another. I'm just like, ugh. Well, I say do it, man. Go for it. Get over here. So let me save this. That's saved. And then we'll close that out. So, okay. Got that taken care of. That's all taken care of. Close that. Okay. Whew. Yeah, it's so complex, it intimidated me. So I was like, I don't know. But now I kind of do want to play something just to ease out of it here, out of these things down, because I got to go in about half an hour. Let's see. What was I playing the other day? Oh yeah, I was playing this. I was playing Batman. I was trying to get into this one because I was watching a video of somebody else playing it. Hold on. Turn that down a bit. Is this thing set up? Yeah, okay, good. And I've just been wanting to play some NES games lately. I'm not sure why. But games are definitely... Hey, play what you like to play. I mean, I think an Ogre Battle stream would be terrific because you'd have so much to share. And you'd have a lot to talk about. And you can share your own strategies and all the details about it. I don't use Twitch, but, you know, I wouldn't... I don't know if I'll be able to watch it, but I'd love to know. I'd love to see how you play it. Oops. Ooh. One annoying thing about this game is that after you land from a jump, you can't punch immediately. It's very annoying. There's some instances where you'll need to land and you won't be able to attack the enemy in front of you right away. I realize that probably just means use ranged weapons, but... There's another one or not? I don't think so. Okay. There we go. All right, buddy. Oops. Boy, my timing's bad. There we go. Yahoo! Wee-hee! need to stand up and then turn this off. There we go. So what are you guys gonna do with the rest of your day? Just chill out? It's Friday. You guys all done with work? I mean, my work still hasn't started yet, but hopefully it won't be a very busy day. Last night was surprisingly light for me, so not super light, but better than I expected. One thing I learned about this game is that Batman has basically only two heights to his jump. You tap it, he does that. You hold it, he does that. But there's really nothing in between. But knowing that, you can kind of use it to your advantage, so you know when you're gonna make a jump and when you're not. Oh, cool! Nice, Lucas Boy, I'll be listening. I could probably run up and punch him, but... These little guys, man, these little things. They're like those things in Star Wars, what are they called, the gonk droids? So irritating. They cause more trouble than almost any other enemy. To wit. Is that a shortcut? Can I use that as a shortcut? Yes, I can. I keep thinking of doing where you draw stuff and paint. Sidetrack. That'd be cool. You should do that. Gonks have legs. Mouse droids are the ones that buzz all... Oh, okay. Thank you. I don't know. I'm not up on that stuff, but I know what you're talking about. I knew that wasn't quite right. Okay, dang it. Mouse droids. But yeah, that's what those guys look like. Yeah. You can set up a mouse droid to advertise for you. That's pretty clever. I like that. Woo! He's gonna slash me, that bastard. He's gonna finish me off like Carl Weathers in Predator. Rest in peace. Press F, chat. Press F for Carl Weathers and Richard Lewis while we're at it. Ah! This mouse droid is not advertising. There we go. It's kicking my ass, is what it's doing. Oh, I forgot about that guy. I never really learned how to deal with him. Whoa! Nope, not good. Not good. Sorry, I don't watch wrestling. Is this Virgil someone who passed away? Ah, okay, that worked out alright. Not good, that was a mistake. Oh, shit! Mouse droids. Mouse droids, man. Oh, that, I'm not handling that one well. There we go. Gotta duck and stay ducked. Thank you. knew you were coming. I knew it. Oh, you little bastard. Move, move, move. Dunk. There we go. Dirk. There we go. The gun. I got too close. Oh, too close again. There we go. Jeez. Jump. Whew. No problem, Lucas boy. Oh, I thought the Jader was there. Okay, never mind. Across. Shit. Not good. Not good at all. That was a bad situation. That was bad. Got through it okay, though. Not good. There we go. Oh, I thought I could make it. Go. There we go. There we go. Oh, man. There we go. Oh, I gotta go down that way. Yeah. Silly. Here we go. Alright. Okay, I'm not really sure what to do about this guy. This is the way I can go. Alright. Okay, it gets tough here. Yeah. Dang it, I still don't really know how to deal with that guy. It's easier if there's a different, a slightly higher ledge beneath him. In front of him, rather. Oh geez, it's already two? I'm gonna have to go. Well, that's okay. We'll stop at this point here. Let me look at this again. I want to go back to this real quick. Before we close up, I just want to take a look at this one more time. It'll take a little bit to load, though. It's taking a while to get going. Okay. So that looked turned out pretty well. Let me,
A common beginner's mistake. Why, I remember when I first started needing it to get into my mouth.
Wait. I've got it. What if we prayed it into our mouths?
Prayed it into our mouths, eh? We've tried everything else. Let's begin.
Yeah, oh, well, I will have to make him, he can't stay like that pose the whole shot, so I will have to do, after I have the Commodore say his line, he'll probably look at us and do a shrug. I'll ask Pac-Billy what he thinks. After I do that, he'll have to go back to his neutral pose. But that, well, I can do that in probably about 4 or 5 frames. Shouldn't be too bad. But anyway, I think we got this. I'm pretty proud of how it turned out. I'm glad I took care of this. So, let's see. I want to look at something else here. What's going on? There was one I had on. Okay, yeah.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
I'm really happy with that. I'm going to watch it one more time.
What if we prayed it into our mouth?
Okay, I'm glad. I'm glad that worked out. Made some progress. Got some stuff done there. I'm pretty happy. Yeah. We'll keep going, and I'll keep working on it tomorrow. I don't know if I'll stream it tomorrow, but I'll definitely get some more progress done. I'll probably do more gaming streams after this instead, but we'll see. It was a lot of fun. So, games are Lucas Boy. I don't know if Double's still there anymore, but if he is still there, thank you. Thank you guys for coming. Thanks for stopping in. I really appreciate you guys coming in and watching a crazy animation stream, which I know is not always fun and not as exciting, but I appreciate you spending some time with me. I feel really happy and honored that you did so, and I really appreciate your compliments. Thank you. Again, I'm honored also, Games are, for you showing the cartoon to your wife. That makes you feel special. I appreciate it. Thank you. You guys too. Hopefully I will have fun. I'll be listening to your stream later, Lucas Boy. You guys have a great night, okay? We'll wrap things up here. We'll see you. Talk again soon. Bye-bye.